Next is about L forms of bacteria. So what do you know about L forms of bacteria? We have mentioned in the previous slide that L forms of bacteria are also known as L phase bacteria or L phase variants, and also it is known as cell wall deficient bacteria. These are the strains of bacteria that lack cell walls, and they were first isolated in 1935 by Emmy Kleinberger Nobel, who named the L forms after Lister Institute in London where she was working. Two types of L forms are distinguished. First one is unstable L forms. Unstable L forms are those in which the spheroblast, unstable L forms are spheroblast. We will discuss later about the spheroblast. Spheroblast that are capable of dividing but can revert to original morphology, which is capable of dividing and change to original morphology also. Stable L forms are those L forms that are unable to revert to its original morphology. So two types of L forms are present. Some parasitic species of bacteria such as Mycoplasma also lack cell wall. Mycoplasma we have discussed in the previous slide, which is an intracellular pathogen which lacks cell wall, but these are not considered as L forms. Why? Because they are not derived from the bacteria that normally have cell walls. Now next is the appearance and cell division of L forms. Already I have shown the picture of L forms in previous session. L form, a black and white picture. The bacterial morphology, it is determined by the cell wall. Actually, the morphology of bacteria, it is determined by the cell wall. Since this L form have no cell wall, its morphology is different from that of the strains of the bacteria from which it is derived. So the L forms which have no cell wall and the morphology of the L forms are quite different from the strains from which these L forms are derived. Typical L forms cells are spheres or spheroids. They are mainly spheres. For example, L forms of the rod shaped bacteria Bacillus subtilis. Actually, this Bacillus subtilis is a rod shaped bacteria, and the L forms of this bacteria also appear round in shape. Actually, the Bacillus shape is rod shaped, but the L forms of this bacteria appear round when viewed under phase contrast microscopy or by transmission electron microscopy. Next, L forms can develop from either gram positive as well as from the gram negative bacteria. And while performing gram staining test with these L forms, they always appear as gram negative due to the lack of cell wall. Next is about cell division. The cell wall is an important for the cell division in a bacteria. So in which the multiplication mainly occur by binary fission. And if this process require a cell wall and also the components of bacterial cytoskeleton. The ability of the L form bacteria to grow and divide in the absence of this cell wall as well as the components of bacterial cytoskeleton, it is highly unusual and it may represent, and in this type of bacteria, L forms, they represent a form of cell division that was important in the early forms of life. In the early forms of life, cell division is quite different from the present time. So, in the L forms, the mode of cell division is usually present in the early forms of life. The novel mode of division seems to involve The extension of it forms a thin protrusion extend from the cell surface, and this protrusion later pinch off from the original L form to form a new cells. That is the mode of division in the L forms. The lack of cell wall in L forms means that the division is disorganized and it gives rise to a variety of cell sizes from very tiny to very big. So while we are looking the diagram or electron microscopic view of these L forms, we can see the spheres in different sizes, either small or big, like that. Next is generation in cultures. How they can be generated? L forms can be generated in the laboratory from many bacterial species that are usually having cell walls, such as Bacillus subtilis, Escherichia coli. This Bacillus subtilis, it is a rod-shaped bacteria. Escherichia coli, it is a gram-negative bacilli. From these bacteria, L forms can be generated in the laboratory. This can be done how? By inhibiting peptidoglycan synthesis, either using antibiotics or treating the cells with the enzyme lysozyme that we have mentioned in the previous slide, which is an enzyme that digests cell walls. The L forms are generated in a culture media that is in the same osmolarity as the bacterial cytosol. So, we can also generate these L forms in a culture medium with same molarity as those which are present in the bacterial cytosol, that is an isotonic condition, which prevent the cell lysis by osmotic shock. The L form strains can be unstable, which means it have a tendency to revert to its normal form of the bacteria by regrowing a cell wall. So, there is a tendency of the L forms to revert to its normal form of bacteria by the forming what? A cell wall. But in the laboratory, this can be prevented by long-term cultures of the cell under the same conditions that were used to produce them, letting the wall is either mutating, mainly causing the mutation, that is, these mutations to accumulate what? Genetic drift. By causing mutation, this may result in the accumulation of a genetic drift. So this prevents the L forms to revert back to its original form, and the L forms can be in this L form type by a long term in cultures. Another methodology of induction of these L forms, it may depend upon the nanotechnology and landscape ecology. These are the latest techniques to make the L forms, generate those L forms in the cultures. Microfluidics devices can be built in order to challenge peptidoglycan synthesis by extreme spatial confinement. These are the later technologies to maintain the L forms. After biological dispersal through a constricted biological corridor connecting to microhabitat patches, L forms can be derived using microfluidics based ecosystem. That first we have mentioned, the methodology of induction relies upon nanotechnology and landscape ecology. This helps to implement an adaptive landscape selecting for the shape-shifting phenotypes which are similar to L forms. So this can be induced using the later technologies such as nanotechnology and landscape ecology. Next is significance and applications of these L forms. Some publications have suggested that this L form bacteria might cause diseases in humans and other animals. But as the evidence that links these organisms to disease It is fragmentary and frequently contradictory. This hypothesis remains controversial. Certain publications say that these alphons are responsible for causing disease in humans and in other animals, but it remains as a hypothesis. It is not proven. The two extreme viewpoints on this question are that alphon bacteria are either laboratory curiosities of no clinical significance, or either or it can be important but unappreciated cause of diseases. Either it can be remain as a curiosity or it remain unappreciated. Research on alphon bacteria is continuing even till now also. For example, this alphon organism has been observed in mouse lungs after experimental inoculation with Nocardia caviae, and a recent study suggests that this organism may infect immunosuppressed patients who have undergone bone marrow transplants. These are the latest studies. Next is the formation of strains of bacteria lacking cell walls has also been proposed to be important in the acquisition of bacterial antibiotic resistance. So, some are saying the formation of this L-forms of bacteria has been proposed. It is an important cause of acquisition of what? Bacterial drug resistance. L-forms are responsible. Some studies are suggesting like this L-forms responsible for antibacterial drug resistance. So, these are all about L-forms. Okay, one more point. L-form bacteria may be useful in either research on early forms of life and also in the biotechnology. And these strains are being examined for the possible use in biotechnology as host strains for the recombinant protein production. So the useful character of this L-forms, this is the application mode of the L-forms, which can be used in the recombinant protein production in the host strains. So this can be used as host strains. L-forms can be used in biotechnology as host strains for the recombinant protein production. Here, the absence of the cell wall can allow the production of large amount of secreted proteins that would otherwise accumulate in the periplasmic space of the bacteria. So, important applications are in the field of biotechnology. So, it can be used for the to find out to make the research on the early forms of life. So, we can this L-forms are used in the research field to study about early forms of the life, and also it is used in the study of biotechnology in the recombinant protein production. These are all about L-forms. Then you can, if you want more points, you can refer standard textbooks and collect the points. Thank you.